Last week, I posted a video sharing with you the 5 tips on managing personal finances, from saving to investing. For me, being good with money is about setting priorities, not completely depriving yourself. So if you've taken care of your money goals and priorities, I don't think you should feel guilty about treating yourself. I splurge on myself now and again, but I try to be mindful with my shopping because it really helps me to spend within my budget. And I also tend to only buy things that I absolutely love. So today, I want to share with you the 6 simple steps on how you can shop mindfully. The first step is to create a wish list and then try to stay the course and not do impulse purchases. This, however, doesn't mean your wish list should be set in stone, because I understand things can change, but the whole point is to cultivate a more conscious spending habit. For example, I might have come across a handbag that would really fit in my lifestyle and my wardrobe, and it might also be a better deal compared to the one on my wish list. So you can certainly adjust your wish list as you go along, as long as you stay within your budget. Furthermore, doing this also gives you the chance to put together a list of things that you love to have, so then you can focus your research on these items to see if they will actually work for you, rather than eyeing on everything under the sun. After you've created your wish list, step 2 is to decide what you're ready to pay full price for, and similarly, what you're only willing to buy on sale. Personally, I love using ShopTagr to get some fantastic discounts on my wishlist items. I've used it for 2 years now. It's an amazing app because it really does make shopping so much easier. I can save all my wishlist items on it, and when these pieces go on sale, ShopTagr will send me a notification. So if you've decided to not pay full price for a certain item, save it on ShopTagr and forget about it until the sale is on. So this is how it works. Basically, all you need to do is download the ShopTagr browser button, and when you go on your favorite store and see something you like, just save it and you'll get a push notification by email or on your phone when your item goes on sale. You can also separate your wishlist items into different categories. I find that really helps to keep things organized. ShopTagr has also recently added another feature that I absolutely enjoy. Basically, at checkout, they will show you all the available coupons that you can apply to your purchase. Yet another way to save money when you shop. This app is completely free to download. You can find the link in my description box down below, and I'm sure you'll love it. Step 3. So now you've created a wish list and you're watching for certain items to go on sale, it's time to tackle your impulse spending. Because let's face it, we all have days when we just want to go out shopping and buy beautiful things. Now, I've not always been good at this, but I find delaying your purchases can really help to reduce impulse shopping. So try to sit on it for 2 days if you are dying to buy something unplanned, and see if you still want it in 2 days. If not, then you know you can move on. Honestly, there have been so many times when I've added things to my basket online and then I just completely forgot about it in 2 days. And that, for me, is a very good sign that I didn't like those items that much anyway. In fact, many times I actually thank myself for not caving in and buying on impulse. Tip number 4 to shop more mindfully is to only buy pieces that are 100% right for you. Now, I've touched on this several times on my channel because I truly believe your hard-earned money should only be spent on things which are absolutely perfect for you. Personally, I also always remind myself about the hassles I'll have to go through to sell something if it doesn't work out for me. I've sold a number of pieces from my wardrobe, and I always try my best to be a responsible seller by taking good pictures, writing detailed descriptions, and packaging the items carefully. Although I'm very grateful that I can still recoup some money that way, selling is still a very time-consuming task. So now, I always try to shop more mindfully, and that really helps to reduce future hassles and shopping regrets. Tip number 5 for intentional shopping is to know your sizes and measurements, especially for your wishlist items, just so when these items go on sale, you can grab them quickly before they're sold out. More importantly, if you love online shopping like me, knowing your sizes can also help to reduce a lot of exchanges and returns. Now, I don't get to go out for shopping a lot now, but when I do, I try to be organized and check the sizes for the pieces I'm interested in. As for my makeup products, I also note down details like the shade for my foundation and eyebrow pencil. It really does save a lot of time when I have to replenish, especially because I use the same products every day. The last step to a more mindful shopping habit is to not buy last minute, because buying last minute quite often means you are paying more. For example, if you're shopping for a gift the day before the occasion, you're quite likely to have to pay more for next day delivery. Whereas if you plan ahead, you could have benefited from the free shipping, which usually will take about 3 to 5 working days. For me, I try to be organized when I shop for my skincare products. As soon as a product goes to about a quarter of its content, I start being more alert to discounts and offers. Usually, I shop for my products on Look Fantastic, where I can find some amazing deals. And of course, I receive sale notifications by ShopTagr, so I can act quickly. The aim is to replenish my products in good time, just so I don't have to buy when I'm desperate and end up paying more than I have to. Worse still, if your item of choice is out of stock, you might also end up with something less than ideal while paying more. There you have it. Those are the 6 simple steps you can follow if you're hoping to shop more mindfully. Personally, they've worked very well for me, so I really hope you'll find them helpful. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!